Ladies and gentlemen, KSI is doubling down with the cope. If you guys don't know what I'm talking about, last week, literally on September 16th, this was how freaking long ago? Like a week and 2 days, Dan TDM put out this tweet saying, "What happened to YouTubers? I can't not say anything anymore. They're selling stuff for the sake of making money. Simple. How does this benefit their fans? This is selling crap to kids who don't know better than to trust the people who are selling it to them. Do better." Something as simple as that in response to their knockoff Lunchables brand. KSI continues to cope, right? He's still talking about this almost a week later, saying this whole Dan TDM and Lunchly beef really shows that I'm in the thick of it. Out October 4th. Pre-save the link down below. And he has a link to his stupid website. And honestly, this is just funny. He's trying to use the fact of him and Logan getting absolutely decimated by their stupid, horrible response videos as a way to promote their crappy music, right? Even his newest video, Why Would You Even Confess This, completely unrelated to the Lunchables situation, is at 16,000 dislikes and only 24,000 likes. Mind you, before all of this drama, people didn't really have a issue with JJ, with KSI. If anything, people kind of supported KSI because, you know, they're comparing KSI to Logan and Mr. Beast, obviously not the greatest people, and they were like, well, what does KSI have to do with this? They haven't done anything. He's done nothing. And how quick the tide changes as 16,000 dislikes now in just that video. His original video, Everybody Hates Us Right Now, where he was talking about the drama, is at 194,000 dislikes now. This is from the YouTube dislike removal adder, whatever, blah, 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 extension, by the way. And he kind of goes on again, this time in response to Marquise Brownlee's new app that lets you buy wallpapers. I didn't make a video on that because it's just stupid in general, but you can probably find plenty of videos out there. Marquise Brownlee is getting canceled for trying to sell a $50 a year subscription for a wallpaper app. Obviously stupid. You can just go on Google, type in something you like, screenshot it, save it, type in free wallpapers, and boom, you have it. But anyways, it's a harmless app, right? Yeah, it costs $50 a year. Yeah, it's scummy. Yeah, that's overpriced and stupid, but it doesn't hurt anyone. It's just a celebrity saying, hey, here's an app. You can buy wallpapers. You can watch ads to buy them, right? And KSI tweeted out, you know, basically a meme on Dan TDM, literally reposting his comment saying, what happened to YouTubers, man? I can't say anything anymore. This is selling stuff for the sake of making money. Simple. How does this benefit their fans? This is selling crap to kids who don't know better than to trust the people who are selling it to them. Do better. Some dumbass YouTuber said this exact same thing to me the other day. Rather than complaining, crying, and trying to cancel a YouTuber for creating a product, here's an idea. If you don't want / like a product, just don't buy it. Simple. Like, this is such a nothing statement, because obviously, first of all, Marquise Brownlee's not trying to sell food products with an attempt to say that it's healthier or better than the competitor. He's literally just created a wallpaper app that's overpriced and stupid, and if you're dumb enough to buy a $50 a year subscription to a wallpaper app full of stock images or badly generated AI, you know, pictures. I don't know what all's on there. You're more than welcome to check it out. But that's not even comparable. It's not even in the same ballpark as creating products for children, for your young audience, with an illusion that it's healthy, that it somehow is better for you because it has more, you know, what is it that they're trying to promote it as? Electrolytes. That's their big selling point. Electrolytes. We perfectly engineered a perfectly sized Prime bottle with the just amount of electrolytes and blah, 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 blah. Right. And that's the whole idea of it. Now we have KSI again promoting his crappy music, and now he's trying to cope. Still, mind you, a week and 2 days later, he's still talking about this nonsense. Mind you, again, literally before all of this drama was going down, before JJ dropped a response video, before he decided to keep going crazy on Twitter, trying to beef with Dan TDM, no one had an issue with him. Again, now his videos are being mass disliked. You have people in his comments saying peace is never an option. Get away from Logan, man. He's ruining your rep. KSI brother, please stay away from Logan. You're going to be in a cult soon. You ain't getting away with this, little bro. What happened to YouTubers, man? No one cares about your songs, bro. Just put the fries in the bag. We lost him, boys. KSI sold his soul. Hang around scumbags long enough and this crap will rub off on you. This is what happens. This is why you don't involve yourself with internet beef. You're going to collect your bag. Collect it. Promote your crappy product that's unhealthy for kids, unhealthy for adults, unhealthy for everyone. Make your silly music. Go star in your best friend, Mr. Beast, and Logan's videos. But the second you start going online, basically crapping on YouTubers that are, you know, more influential than you in good ways, not in, you know, involvement with, you know, drama and being in forests in Japan, things like that, you're going to involve yourself in these types of internet wars. And you're not going to win because on no matter what sub you go on now, you go on YouTube drama, you'll go on Mr. Beast drama Reddits. It's going to be KSI's name now. People are watching your every little move because you made a big mistake. Sell your products, take people's money, do what you do best. Stay out of drama because you have now ruined, at least for a while. I don't know how long this will last. People might just forget it in a week or two from now, but you have ruined your reputation and your good graces with a lot of the people in your community and just on YouTube in general. Ladies and gentlemen, that's just about it for today's video on the KSI drama update. The tip of the iceberg is only slowly starting to unravel. It went from, you know, the daily, weekly Mr. Beast content, that well's kind of dried up. You know, there's rumblings. I'm waiting. I'm watching. I watch everything. So if you guys like these kinds of videos, consider liking and subscribing and sharing. But as always, I'll keep you guys up to date on everything happening with your favorite or least favorite YouTubers. Let me know what you think about everything. I've already kind of given my feedback and opinions on all of this. I kind of feel like if KSI would have just kept his mouth shut, you know, if he just stayed quiet, again, people would have just kind of focused more on Logan Paul and focused more on Mr. Beast. But the fact that KSI made a response, it caused Logan to make a response, and now KSI keeps doubling down, is continuing to involve himself in situations, and now involving himself in other people's weird marketing tactics and apps and whatnot. And again, all of this could have even resolved if he just didn't say anything at all. That's like the golden rule of content creation is just if you don't know 100% if something is going to cause feedback or some type of like negative loop, then just don't do it. Just don't bother saying it. You know, type up your rant and then press backspace and just let it all be. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed the video. Peace out. Thank you for watching, my friends. Like, subscribe, share. Bye.